Hello friends, myself Dr. Sandip Banerjee and I am a consultant laparoscopic surgeon, bariatric and colorectal surgeon. So I am practicing in my clinic which is called Pelvinic, and also I am also a head surgeon in Apollo Spectra Kailash Colony. So today I am going to talk about benign anorectal conditions, which are problems involving your anus and rectum, and which is involving a large amount of population in our country. So the primary problem arising out of this is because of a constipation, and constipation is affecting almost 13% of the population, much higher than what diabetes and hypertension is affecting our population. So because of a constipation, there are few problems which happen day in day out for in a routine life, and involves any group, any class of patients. The first thing which I'm going to discuss is a fissure in ano, and fissure is a painful condition in anus, which mostly is because of an ulcer formation or the breach of skin in the anus, which develops due to the passage of a hard stool. And the main symptoms out of it is a painful difficulty to sit, postural problems and painful defecation, with a minimum association of passage of minimum amount of fresh amount of blood during defecation. The solution lies in the treatment with medical management mostly, and 70 to 80% of the patient benefit out of the medical management. Only the remaining of the patients who develop a chronic fissure, who are not being cured by medical management, they are the one fit for surgery. The second one is in hemorrhoids, which are called piles. So all of us do have an anal cushions normally, and which once gets prolonged due to chronic straining, develop pathological piles. Now the piles, we grade it according to the size of them and the type of problems which patients are facing. It can be graded from grade 1 to grade 4. The initial grade piles, which are grade 1 and 2, in which the patients do have problems related to it, like bleeding or mucus discharge or some sort of difficulty while passing stool. But there is no history or no complaints of something coming out of the anus. So these are the early grade piles, and the early grade piles, either they need some sort of a treatment in terms of form of medicine, or at times when it is really bothersome, then we do advise some non-surgical treatment like laser, radio frequency ablation, cryotherapy and even banding. But for the hemorrhoids, which are quite big, like grade 3 and 4, in which the patients mainly complains of something coming out of the anus and they need to manually reposition it, so they are the one which needs a definitive surgery. And the surgery which has come lately and with a high success rate is a stapler surgery for hemorrhoids. And the stapler surgery, which has been used for last 10-15 years, is seen with a lot of success, and that has revolutionized the pile surgery, in which the patients only need a day in a hospital, goes back to home without any pain, without any problems there so after, with chances of recurrence even less than 0.001%. Then there are some acute conditions in which you develop an abscess in the anus, and you must know that abscess in the anus should always be drained, should always be surgically drained, and there is no other way just to linger it on with the medications, because if an abscess in the anus or the perianal region is being neglected, that abscess may develop into a tract which is called a fistula, and once you have developed a fistula, then it's very difficult to treat. Now fistula in anus is a tract which is connecting the outer skin with an inner anus. So what happens is that a patient, once they develop a fistula, they have a typical complaints of persistent perianal discharge in forms of pus, and then suddenly the discharges ends, and then patients are quite okay, and then a few days later they develop some sort of a swelling, there is severe pain, and then sudden the discharges again comes back. So this way the cycle goes on, and it develops into a complex tract. So fistula, it's very important to know what is the tract of a fistula, and while treating a fistula we see whether it's in a high or a low fistula. So low fistula need not need any further imaging things, because out of experience we can find it out while doing proctological examinations that it's a low fistula, and low fistula have a very high success rate of surgical cure, whereas in high fistula it requires a some sort of an MRI imaging, and this MRI imaging helps us to know the different type of tracts. And once knowing the tracts, we need to bring in some sort of different forms of surgery based on the tract. It can be a laser, it can be radio frequency ablation, it can be a VAF surgery, it can be a lift surgery, based on the complex nature of the fistula. The cure rate is having a recurrence rate of 3 to 7% world over. And I've been using radio frequency ablation for different difficult type of fistulas. Even laser has been applied, and I've met with quite a good amount of success in my patients. Two other things which I want to discuss is about rectal prolapse. Now, the patients do complain of, you know, something coming out as a chunk through the anus while defecation, and it's a quite a big amount as compared to hemorrhoids. And patients do have a problem associated with rectal prolapse. Either they have a chronic diarrhea or a constipation. So it can be either constipated prolapse or a diarrheal prolapse. And for that too, it needs a treatment, and the definitive treatment is a surgery, and it involves a laparoscopic cure from the abdomen. And the last is pilonidal sinus, and pilonidal sinus develops a small chronic discharging fissure in between the buttocks, and that also needs a very good flap surgery. So hope you will like this information, and for any type of solution, any type of cure, you can contact me either in Pelvinic or through Librate or in Apollo Spectra Kailash Colony. Thank you.